Hello friends, welcome to the video tutorials of Advanced Java Programming. In this session we will discuss about Unit 6, that is a fiber net. This is Rajul Suthar, Assistant Professor of Sri Swaminarayan Institute of Technology. Please like and subscribe the channel. So why we use the fiber net? Before starting the fiber net, let me check some fundamental about the fiber net. With the establishment of World Wide Web, the demand for database has increased and almost every application is using database. We can say that foundation of most commercial application like large scale storage of ordered information such as a catalog, customer list, contract details, publisher tags, as well as architectural design, all things we required large database. While demand for such an application and database have grown, but their development has yet not become visible or simple. Some standards are increased using the enterprise Java bin, ETB. But unfortunately, EGB, many others model had suffered one or more way because of the mismatch between the relational model and the object-oriented model. In short, database persistency was difficult at that time. A solution to achieve the such a persistency, some sort of object relational mapping, that is called ORM, is appropriate for EGB, and traditional relational database is appropriate for basic static application. Most of the developers personally think that Hibernet represent a good or first choice, and it does not stop the simultaneously use of other alternative approach. To more convenient the use of Hibernet, let's see the difference between Hibernet and JDBC. So which are the main difference between Hibernet and JDBC? JDBC the database specific, where a Hibernet code will work well for the database, for example Oracle, MySQL, etc. JDBC one need about the SQL, where no knowledge of SQL is needed in Hibernet. Here Hibernet automatically generate the HQL query. We will discuss each and every step one by one. Let me start the session. First, Hibernet introduction. Hibernet is used to convert the object data in Java to relational database table. Here the use of Hibernet, like we want to convert the object data in Java to relational database tables. It is an open source object relational mapping OR mapping, that is called object relational mapping for Java. Hibernet is responsible for making the data persistent by storing it in database. What is OR mapping or object relational mapping? It is the programming technique for converting object type data of object oriented programming language into the database table. Hibernet is used to convert object data in Java to relational database table. Here let me check the details difference between JDBC as well as Hibernet. So previously in the starting of session, we already discussed the JDBC as well as Hibernet. JDBC mapped the Java class to database table and from Java data types to SQL data type. It convert Java data types to SQL data type, that is called structure query language. While in Hibernet, automatically generate the query. In second step, with the JDBC, developer has to write the code to map an object model's data to the relational data models. While in Hibernet, it is a flexible and powerful OR mapping to map the Java class to database table. With the JDBC, it is a developer's responsibility to handle the JDBC result set and convert it to the into Java. So with the JDBC mapping between Java object and database table is done manually. While in Hibernate reduced line of code, it required the less number of line of code and maintaining the object table mapping itself and return the result to application in form of Java object, hence reducing the development time and maintenance cost. Again, it required JDBC driver for different type of database. We all familiar in second chapter various type of driver like type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. Thin driver as well as thick driver used. While in Hibernate, it make an application portable to all SQL database. JDBC handle all create, read, update, delete. So that is called the data manipulation language as well as data definition language. This operation is using in SQL query. While in Hibernate, it handle all the create, read, update and delete. CRUD means create, read, update and delete. This operation using the simple. It use the simple API. No SQL structure query language is required. In JDBC, working with both object-oriented software and relational database is complicated. This task is very complicated in JDBC. While in Hibernate itself take care of this mapping using XML file, so developer does not need to write the code for this. JDBC support only native structure query language is called SQL, while Hibernate provide the powerful query language that is called Hibernate Query Language (HQL). It is independent from type of database. Let me check the Hibernate framework. So what do you mean by Hibernate framework? Hibernate framework is a simplified the development of Java application to interact with the database. We have to interact means make the communication between database and Java application. Hibernate is an open source lightweight ORM object relational mapping tools. ORM tools simplify the data creation, data manipulation and data access. Hibernate is a programming technique that map the object to data stored and it use in database. It use for programming technique like it mapping, it stored the data in database. Hibernate is a lightweight object relational mapping framework. It used to map the object oriented domain models in a relational database. Initially, the developer used the structure query language. In this, developer used the structure query language. Let me check with the figure. Here, Java application, whatever the Java code is used, we use the object of particular Java application. We use the OR mapping, that is called object relational mapping, and it connect with the database. So this is a simple architecture, or we can say that framework. Here ORM tools internally use the JDBC API to interact with the database. Let me details check of Hibernate architecture. There are four layer in Hibernate architecture. Which four layer? This type of a question asked in GTU exam every time. Most important question. First Java application layer. First layer is called Java application layer. Second, Hibernate framework layer, that is called persistent object. It used to store the persistent object. Then backend API. This backend API layer cover the Hibernate. This is a total Hibernate environment. In this environment, mapping file as well as configuration file will be created. And last is database layer. Last one is called database layer. Backend API also cover the JTA, JDBC as well as JNDI. What is a JTA? JTA means Java Transaction API. Java Transaction API. Then JNDI, that is a Java naming and directory interface, as well as JDBC, we all familiar, Java database connectivity. This is the details architecture. Here JTA, JDBC and JNDI is used. First Java application, then persistent object. This is a Hibernate environment. It stores the configuration, session factory, session, transaction, query and criteria. Then this figure show the comparatively comprehensive architecture of Hibernate in order to persist the data to the database. Hibernate create an instance of entity class, Java class, Hibernate class. It map with the database table. This object is called the transient object, as they are not associated with the session or not yet persistent to the database. To persist the object to database, instance of a session factory or interface is created. Session factory is a it is an instance which implement a factory design pattern. Session factory load the Hibernate configuration file with the help of transaction factory, and connection provide the implementation all the configuration setting to the database. Here Hibernate use the various existing Java API. This is called the Java API. So first JDBC, here JDBC is used, then Java Transaction API JTA is used, as well as Java Naming and Directory Interface, Java Naming and Directory Interface JNDI is used. JDBC provide a one level that is called the rudimentary level, that abstraction of a functionality commonly used for relational database, and it allow almost any database with JDBC driver to support by Hibernate. So this is called a core object of Hibernate framework, and this is an internal API used by Hibernate. What do you mean by persistent? We all familiar, the word persistent means permanent. Persistent simply means that we would like the application data to outlive the applications process. In Java terms, we would like the state of some of our object to live beyond the scope of the JVM, Java Virtual Machine, so that the same state is available later. Available later means we can use anytime, because stored at a permanent. Internal API, this three word, remember Java database connectivity, then JTA, that is a Java transaction API, and JNDI is a Java naming directory interface. For creating the first Hibernate application, we must know the object or element of a Hibernate architecture. They are like configuration, session factory, session, transaction factory, query, criteria. This all are the elements, or we can say that object of Hibernate architecture. Configuration, session factory, session, transaction factory, query and criteria. So what is the use of configuration? Configuration object is the first Hibernate object that we create any Hibernate application, and usually create only once during the application initialization. Then session factory object, configuration object is used to create the session factory object, which is in turn configure the Hibernate for the application using supplied configuration file and allow for session object to be initiated. The session factory is thread safe. This object used by all the thread and its application. Session factory is a heavyweight object, so usually it is created during the application startup and kept for later use. Session object, so this session object, third one, is used to get a physical connection with the database. The session object is a lightweight and designed to instantiated each time an interaction needed with the database. Persistent objects are saved and retrieved through the session object. The session object should not kept open for a long time because they are not usually thread safe. They should be created and destroyed as needed. Then transaction factory. What is the use of transaction object or transaction factory? Transaction factory, it represents the unit of work with the database. Most of the RDBMS support transaction functionality. Transaction hibernate are handled by the underlying transaction manager and transaction from JDBC to JTA. Then query object in a SQL or a query object use SQL or Hibernate query language HQL. The string to retrieve the data from database and create an object. A query instance is used to bind the query parameters, limit to the numbers of result written by the query, and finally to execute a particular query. And last one, criteria. What is the use of criteria? This object are used to create and execute object-oriented criteria for query retrieve object. Used for object-oriented purpose. So this is the configuration object. We require the database connection in the configuration object. So this is handled through one or more configuration files supported by Hibernate. These files are hibernate.property and hibernate.cfg.xml file. Then we require the class mapping setup. So this component create a connection between the Java class and database tables. Session factory is used to configure the object, used to create a session factory object with the term configure Hibernate for the application. So if you are using the multiple database, then you would have to create a multiple session factory object. Session object is used for get a physical connection with database, and this is a lightweight. We can say that it is a thread safe. Transaction object, we were familiar, the unit of work perform the transaction in database. It handled by the transaction manager, JTA and JDBC. Query object, it uses the SQL query, as well as query instance is used to bind a query parameter, limit the number of result written by the query. Last, criteria object is used to create and execute the object oriented criteria, query to retrieve the object. Here Hibernate cache architecture. So first we require the database for interaction with the Java application. This Hibernate is required, first level cache, second session object. This is a client. And the second level cache, that is called optional cache. This type of a figure you have to draw if question asked regarding to the Hibernate cache architecture. Remember this here cache, first level cache as well as second level cache is covered. And this object is bind with the client. Here cache known as a session cache. Session cache is a mandatory cache through which all the requests must be passed from first level cache. And second level cache is mainly responsible for catching the object across the session. Why cache is required? We simple have the knowledge about the cache, that is called faster execution. It is a small amount of memory. So caching is all about application performance optimization. It is situated between your application and database to avoid the number of database hits as many possible, because we can say that our data is available in cache, so can't call every time for the new data. It is available in cache memory. To give the better performance of for the criteria critical application, we require the cache. First level catch is the session catch. The session object keep an object under its own control before committing it to the database. And if you issue the multiple database, multiple update to the object, Hibernate try to delay doing the update as long as possible to reduce the number of update. SQL statement is issued. If you close the session, all the object being cache are lost. Second level cache means it is responsible for catching the object across the session. Second level cache is an optional. This is not a required. The optional cache. And first level cache is always be consulted before any attempt is made to locate an object in the second level. Any third party cache can be used with the Hibernate, and org.hibernate.cache.cache provider. This interface is provided which must be implemented to provide the Hibernate with handled cache implementation. Hibernate mapping types we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you for attending this session.